ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ವೋಟ್ ಹಾಕಕ್ ಮುಂಚೆ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಕ್ರಿಮಿನಲ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವರೇ ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ಮಾಡಲಿ. ಇದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಚಾರ ಕೊಡಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಾಚ್ ಅಂತ ಹೋದ ಸಾರಿ 2004ರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಬುಕ್ಲೆಟ್ ತಂದಿದ್ವಿ. ಈ ಸಾರಿನೂ ಅದು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇದನ್ನ ಇಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಫಾಲೋ ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಯಾರು ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಮಾಡಿರೋರು ಯಾರು ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಾವು ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಸ್ಟ್ಗಳು ಅದನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ಮುಂದೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕೆಲಸ ತುಂಬಾ ಇದೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಸಹಕಾರ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯ.
ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಎಂಡೋರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ತಿರುಚನ್ ಸೆಡ್, ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಡಿಲಿ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಮೋರ್ ಓಪನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ವೇ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವೋಟರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚೂಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದೆಮ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಅನ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಚ್ ತಿರುಚನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ PIL ಇನ್ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ಕೋರ್ಟ್. ಟು ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೇಟಾ is because of citizens initiative. It is not an initiative of the government or of political parties or indeed of the election commission. We have the highest regard for the election commission. It's one of the as Tirochan said, it's an independent statutory body, guaranteed its independence by the constitution, and certainly for the last 10 or 15 years it's played a very important role in in monitoring and assuring fair elections. But this process of declaration of records was initiated by citizens action, and I think it has to be slow, and we have to take heart from what has happened. We can't be impatient, we can't expect the system to be cleaned up totally overnight. The other thing I would like to underline what Tirochan said is that this is a totally non-partisan activity. If it is an activity that is inspired by the ideals of the Indian constitution and the need to make elections free and fair, it has no truck with any political party of any kind. It is neither for any political party nor is it against any political party. I think that's both are important.
The Central Information Commission has given a recent ruling which was also reported mildly in the press. The political parties' income tax returns, the total financial records of political parties, are now available in the public as per the Central Information Commission under the right to information. So I would also request all of you and urge you, please collect the information on the funding of political parties and please write about it. He is asking a very good question. He says, who is financing our activity? Where are we getting the money from? I think, thank you, welcome for asking this. I am going to answer it because it's a very good question. We welcome this in public. We are asking candidates and political parties to give their financial records, and we also are equally responsible for giving this. We started this work by funding it out of our own pocket. Later on, we started collecting money from citizens. People were sending 200, 500, 5,000 rupees, etc. Later on, today, some two major donor agencies have agreed to fund us. I don't mind giving their name, but they may not like it. But we are being funded as a formal NGO by a major donor agency. So there is nothing to hide about it. And we are quite open about that fact because we cannot manage all this all over the country without some donations. One more question she is asking, where is that money coming from? Have you made an analysis? Somebody has declared 50 crores, 100 crores. Where is that money coming from? Actually, we have not done it. Assets they give that I have got land or building. But where I earned that money from, Supreme Court has not asked them to furnish that detail. We are going to take up that issue because in many of the leading democracies around the world, the source of wealth and source of income, yelli inda duddu, so that information in the future we hope to collect.